then before I paint, I usually do a few little value studies. So so sometimes I do a little or a little bigger value studies. So this is the value study I did in preparation for the painting that I sent everybody, and just made it. And this is kind of an easy easy value, just making a big silhouette shape, an interesting action line silhouette. I like the composition, how it leads the eye in. It's kind of a Z formation, this boardwalk to Tower Bridge to this dominant cloud. And that's what I sent everybody. And that painting actually is right here. So we see this Z composition almost, all right? And so that was the first step. And I do value studies, as you can see, there's just really kind of sloppy, but just to give myself a battle plan of where I'm gonna have my whites, my lights, my mids, and my darks. And another way to do a value study is sometimes I just do something really small, like a little tiny thumbnail. So these are just examples of thumbnails that you can kind of experiment with the different lighting. So today we have some really bright lights that was hitting the front and then the side was in shadow. Now that's changed, that light is quickly changing. And then I experimented with, the light coming from a different direction. So, and then, so these are just, you could do a number of these and kind of play with where you want your lights and your whites, your lights and mids and darks. So just different ideas. And some people do them in pencil, some use markers. This happens to be in a gray, like a Payne's gray, neutral tint. So just some different ideas. Okay. So if there's not any other questions, what I'm going to do now is take a sheet of 300-pound Fabriano rough paper, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to wet the back of the paper. So usually when you plane or paint, you don't have it all pre-drawn when you come out. So I did that in order to save some time and also to give everybody an opportunity to have a nice foundational drawing from which to work. So I already had the drawing already completed when I came out here, and I'm pretty much lined up with a similar perspective. So when I usually plein air paint, is what I'll do is I'll take my phone and I'll go on location. I'll take photos and I'll look at my viewfinder and kind of look around and try and find a nice composition with the viewfinder of the phone, taking photos. And then I'll take the image on the viewfinder of the phone and I'll sketch in the big shapes and just make sure everything's going to fit well. And then I'll put the phone away and draw it more completely. All right. So just to let you know kind of the process I go through. So, and then I'm drawing it onto a 300-pound rough Fabriano paper. Now I'm going to take that paper, and if you've taken workshops from me in the past, you've heard me talk about different moisture qualities of paper, working on dry paper, working on dull wet, shiny wet, soaking wet paper, and the different effects I get. And what I'm going to do is to give myself more time to play with the paint on the surface of the paper, I'm going to wet the back of the paper. Okay, so I'm actually flattening the paper and I'm going to spray this back down. And then I'll just take a sponge full of water. And this is exactly what I do when I paint outdoors. This is the process. And I'll wet the back of the paper.